Good morning everyone, welcome back to my channel and welcome to another video. Today we are walking 25 kilometers for Beat as part of Eating Disorder Awareness Week. You can't wait. So we're basically doing a trek through Surrey. Had to get up early this morning. Also realised, because where we're starting is at a train station in
Whitley,
South Downs.
Pretty sure.
Whitley. I was saying it right. So we're gonna have to get the train there, which means we have to walk to a train station this morning, which adds on to our walk, which is already gonna be 26, not 25 kilometers because of the route we're doing. So it's gonna be more like 30 by the end of the day. But hopefully we'll make it through okay.
We'll be fine.
Yeah.
I've got my Ravenclaw hat to keep it.
Should I take a hat?
Well, you'll probably end up taking this one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've got a big hood anyway as well, so I'll be fine. Officially found the starting point after trying to find it after the station. However, there are actually labels for the walk we're doing. So
we literally walk that way and then we walk back.
Oh, did we? So that was the right way. Oh, well, the map just played up. Basically took the long route around from the station, but the map decided that it wanted to play up already. But at least we're on the right way around now.
Have you started your watch?
Oh no, I need to. Right, okay, good reminder. And it's only 2 minutes in. Oh, I don't like this, it's slunchy. It's slippy. Oh, this is disgusting. I reckon you could jump that. Actually, no, don't. We're not even a kilometer in. I can't be losing you yet. We basically have asked for questions via Instagram. One of them, some of them were challenged as well.
Right here.
Yep. Was to see who could climb the tree the highest. Oh, well, a random tree the highest. I hate heights and I have a fear of falling. There's this tree here, which I could sit on. I could get on that branch about, but I can see this going so wrong and I already know which way this challenge is gonna go. I'll let you test it out for me. How sturdy is the branch?
That's moss, that's gonna slip.
Maybe that one's not a good tree. Oh no, you're going in.
Oh, that good.
Yeah?
I said I think.
No. Are you stuck? No. Are you sure? Go on, you got this. Yeah, you're going the wrong way. We're going that way. You thought you were going to fall, so I'm definitely not going up there.
It's not even a high tree, so we're going to try again later.
Oh, I thought that cancelled out the tree challenge. You've won that one. You got higher in the tree.
Ah!
Flipped. Oh, sign?
There's a sign up the top there, so we must go this way.
Okay, good. We sort of took a detour through some woods, but
To find a tree,
but I think we're back on track. Not a bad view to walk out onto. We're how far in? 1.39 kilometers and already the monster's coming out.
I mean, it is 10 past nine, so we're very late to the monster.
Fair. You have had coffee as well this morning at least.
Yeah, coffee's like oxygen now, really.
Can't live without it. Actually, I can.
If you remember from the powerlifting video, if you're a powerlifter, you're an automatic caffeine addict.
That is true.
That's the important part of being a powerlifter, you just become addicted to caffeine. Okay, so we also got asked a question as well, so I put up on my story. This question, we're gonna put it here.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
From George Sweet. Why don't you wear Gymshark leggings more often? I don't know.
We're currently twinning. I've got the green ones on. You've got the black ones on. Oh yeah, look at that quad.
I'm actually in so much comfort. It's so comfortable.
I'm not getting them back ever, am I?
Yeah. George, you'll see them again, don't you worry.
They need to be worn in the gym. They need to come out at some point. Hopefully there's some way of getting around that giant puddle ahead, because I don't want to do this. Ooh, mind the horse poo. Okay, at least there's a side bit. How deep do you, it looks deep as well actually. Oh yeah, 100% she would have been jumping. That is one of the things we've been told, we have to jump in a muddy puddle. but I don't know if either of us is willing to do that. This is disgusting. I'm in deep.
I've got you.
Thank you. Cheers. Look at my shoes.
That's a puddle you can jump in.
What, this one here? Oh no, it's got, no, it's got like weird oily stuff in it. Look, it's
soy sauce.
Let's go. Do a dog count.
Dog count.
How many dogs have we seen on our walk?
Well, if we look that way, there's another dog.
And we saw the group of like three that came at once. There's the man on the road with a dog. I'd say we've seen maybe about six or seven so far.
Yeah,
and we're only 3 kilometres into the walk, so probably going to be many more.
Okay, what questions have you got?
If you could be any age for the rest of your life, what age would you choose? See, being a kid is great because life is just simple. However, 15, 16 was also a really good age. But then some people would be like, but you're not yet legal. But they were. That was like a good couple of years.
I'd say for me, probably, I don't know, 18. Because, you know, you just got a bit excited. You could drive, you could go anywhere that you wanted.
Yeah.
The only thing is that everyone just sees you as really, really young. Which obviously at that time we thought were really, really old.
Yeah.
But second that, I'd say 10. On your 10th birthday, I got spoiled.
Well, I got a phone for my 10th birthday.
Same here.
Yeah. No, that was a good time. But it's like now, right, so you know how like X Factor has the over 25s category? When you're a kid, you're like, oh, evolution.
Yeah.
Now.
I'm 23. That's.
Well, we're both 23.
You are.
So.
You're very young. You know, you're 3 months younger.
I'm only 3 months younger than you. I didn't just nearly slip over in the mud. But. I did. But yeah, like, 25 isn't that old anymore.
No.
It's really not. But yeah, no, definitely, kid life is simple, or if not, like mid-teens.
So 10 or 18, I'd say. Now, the other question which we got asked.
Yeah.
Right here as well. Who wears the best camo leggings? Now, we'll swap you around.
Right, okay, here's mine. I need to pull up the top a little bit so you get the full view. I've got the green ones on, which I prefer personally, they're my favourite.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, and then you've got...
Back again. Get back out.
Oh yeah, you got to show the full thing. Yeah.
So we'll let you decide.
Oh yeah, no, you can choose which leggings look better. Clearly mine, because you know, they're the green ones which are better, but you know.
Clearly mine, yeah.
I see, there's a fallen tree there, but technically, right, who can climb the highest bit? If it's fallen, I just need to sit on that end branch there, right, and I've made it to the top of the tree. Oh, that's a cute little cave. If it starts raining.
Watch your cave in.
Oh, but it's part of a tree, isn't it?
That is a tree.
But it's made it into a really nice little cave.
Oh, Eunice.
You go for it, because I don't trust it. Because look at that, that's like proper snapped there. Actually, yeah, to get through, I'm going to have to climb it, aren't I?
Oh my god.
Actually, no, I've seen a route that I can do that I'll be okay with.
Sure.
Actually, can I cut through there? Oh no, but then it goes down.
Bear Grylls.
Oh yeah, go on.
Your name Bear, because I'm going to grill you tonight.
You didn't just say that, did you? You did.
Stuck here now. Now what?
Oh.
I just shook some stuff onto my head. That was disgusting. Right, what's the best situation? Jump into the middle or just pull across? Okay, I'm going all over.
As long as you make it, that's all that matters, isn't it?
I wouldn't worry
about your dirty hands. How are we going to make it there?
I think I've got this. It's a bit mossy, this last one. Hey!
These views are sponsored by Raw Hartley's Jelly.
That could actually be an advert though. It's the way you just slurped it. Sign says we're going this way, map says we're going this way. The trees, however, say we're going to have to find... Wait, hang on, can you get through over there? Is that another path? or at least can get round somehow.
Yeah, it's a path. That, I think you should do.
Oh, do you think I can get through that?
I reckon so.
Oh, right. There's a lot of trees.
You got, all you need to do is just get up. Okay?
Up over here.
Just up, okay? This can be your tree.
There you go. It's really mossy.
Okay, go up the left bit. Go up the left bit.
What? Up there?
Yeah. Up this that. Up this bit. Here. There you are.
Oh, your turn.
Better I'm doing this one-handed.
Yeah, you are. Good luck.
Oh.
If you fall, it's you that goes and not the camera.
I'll throw the camera to you then, should I, yeah?
Or you know what my catching's like, so I won't catch it. He doesn't look as big on camera. Look at the cow.
I would say we'll walk up that way, but
he's a
they're struggling to walk.
Is it really muddy that way? I'd say we're heading the other way anyway.
Reached our first hurdle. Got sticks.
How did I get stuck in the laces there?
How have you managed that?
I don't actually know.
However, got nice cows.
Oh yeah.
There's a lot of farms around here, isn't there?
Oh yeah.
Oh, this is the best view. How far have we got?
How far have we got? We're 7.993 kilometres in.
Very nice.
Barely out the 8 kilometre mark. Let me find some more questions. How excited are you for Harry Potter?
Well, how excited are you, first of all? Let's start with that.
On a scale of what?
Let's say on a scale of Avada Kedavra. To Expecto Patronum.
That means nothing to me.
Basically, scale of 1 to 10.
Okay. I'm excited for a trip to London.
Yeah.
And donut time, you get which to is see in the theatre.
Get to see your sister as well.
Yeah. So for that, I'd say a solid, 9. The Harry Potter part itself, they still need to make it through the rest of the films, first of all.
We've got all day tomorrow, so it's a recovery day.
Oh, 100%.
Oh, look at this hurdle we've got.
Oh, is it? Yeah, changing tree.
This is assuming we're on the right path.
We may have gone slightly wrong. However, it'll be a fun adventure.
But there's a will, there's a way.
Eggs.
So you're quite excited, yeah?
Yeah, quite excited. For London. The show. I'm sure it'll be a great entertaining show, and if you love Harry Potter, I'm sure it'll be amazing.
Yeah.
However, I just didn't grow up with Harry Potter at all. However, you, on a scale of 1 to 10, are probably on 100.
I'm on, there's no words that can describe how I'm feeling.
They're not.
Oh, amazing.
I'm just looking at this that we've currently got to get through. It's going to be a bit sludgy. Look at the state of my shoes.
That. Yeah, I did. That was probably
just you, not the shoes. Oh, yeah, clearly.
I'm probably
going to
do it no better.
Go on. Oh, okay, I didn't get too much dirt on my hand. We're all good. So you've kind of taken a little bit of a detour. Oh, there we go, the lighting's kind of reflecting off it. Excuse my really disgusting nails. However, we're going to try and link back around that way. Hopefully get back on there, because that would have just been along a road and we decided, we'll take the scenic route, and it has paid off. Not that there's a brilliant view right now because it's so foggy, but that would be amazing on a really nice day. That would be an incredible view. Turns out we took the right detour because we got the scenic route and we've literally come right out onto the track where we need to be. So actually, we're geniuses.
All I'm saying, the first expedition of the Antarctic probably did the exact same.
Oh yeah.
We probably took a massive detour, took the scenic route.
Yeah.
Now look at us, we're here. I think we've done very well.
I think that's great. And how many kilometres are we on? We're on 8.72, we've almost done 9. Getting close to 9 kilometres.
There we go.
What's halfway? 12.5, although we're doing 26 to 13.
Yeah.
So in another 4 kilometres, we'll be at the pub.
Sour Patch Kids, I think.
Right, so betting on number of steps we would have done just on this, what though, total today?
Total today.
Oh, in that case, because I took off what I'd done for the train station.
So I'm going 48,000.
You're going 48. In that case, I'll go 44.
Should we give her 2,000 leeway?
Okay.
If we're doing a bet.
Yeah.
Tomorrow, whoever loses.
Yeah.
Has to buy the
winner.
Because we're going to be buying some food tomorrow, aren't we? Okay.
Buy some food. Okay. Shake on it.
What are you eating, by the way?
Candy kittens. They're the vegan sweets. They're sweet raspberry and guava. Can't say I've ever had a guava, but it tastes nice in a sweet form.
Well, I just devoured a load of Sour Patch Kids, and to all my powerlifters out there, if you know, you know. I think I got that. If you know, you know. If you go to a powerlifting meet in the warm-up room, all it smells like is sweat, Monster, and Sour Patch Kids.
Oh, lovely!
It's amazing.
I can't wait for my first experience of going to a powerlifting meet.
You'll love it. Don't worry.
I'm not competing, by the way.
You are.
I'm just supporting.
How we doing?
We're doing okay. It's a bit sludgy. Oh my god, I hadn't even seen the state of my boots. Oh, there's mud on my sock.
Oh, bless.
I know. Oh.
So I got asked a couple of questions as well.
I say, go on, get some more out.
One by Nick Townsend. So this is actually Rory's client who I pick up when we go to Dover.
Okay, nice.
He asked, you got the bag. You got the bag. If you know, you know. I know it's nothing to do with what you think it is, but you got the bag.
Do you know what this is? Am I confused?
Have you got the bag?
I don't know.
She's got the bag. Right, we've got one from, his name is Naughty, well, on his thing it's Naughty Calzone. However, his name's Callum Pierce and I went to college with him. He said, when are you gonna get huge? If you're on about height,
I think you've reached your max height.
Yeah, I think I've reached my max potential. I tried my hardest. My next question is, Mo said to me, can you scare Soph? So I just did.
You did. I even half saw that on there. I was like, oh, I bet that's what you're going to do. And it still scared me.
10K?
We've done 10 kilometers. And I was thinking the pub would look closer. It's about 3 kilometers away. It's still all that way away.
Up to pub.
So say, in terms of the actual route, it still looks quite far away. I was hoping if I zoomed out and make it look closer.
I'd say it's about 2 kilometres.
Oh, hello. This is definitely my favourite field so far. You've got the little pony, oh, my glove's in the way. And then you've got the donkey. There's some sheep saying hello over there.
I'm a donkey on the edge. So much for noble steed.
Look at him! You're just giving all the Shrek references. Did you ever used to do donkey rides on the beach as a kid?
No, I never went to Skeg.
Yeah, but it's not just Skeggy. You can do it elsewhere. Oh, I used to love a donkey ride on the beach. What? Wait, hang on, what's he doing?
I think he's scratching.
Oh, hello, mate. They've got really big noses.
Snouts.
I never realised that before. Oh, well, see, it's like a trip to the farm today. Go on. Are you gonna? Oh, there's a decent amount of log. You may actually be all right. Meanwhile, my foot's just stuck in here. Oh! Did you hear that?
We just witnessed our first slipping.
I fell.
We're having to adopt the new method.
At least I found a nice little bit of grass to land on.
She literally, her arse print is there.
Because anywhere else would be really spiky. But I've now had water will seep into my shoe. And it's really muddy.
Go on, it can only get better. Come on, let's go.
I was going to say, do you reckon this is like, you know how you can go to this place where you can go and choose your Christmas tree and chop it down? Because there's a massive field full of them.
It's a couple of acres, though.
It is? I don't know what an acre is. I don't use acres. But I'll take your word for it.
Well, you need to know 100 acres is where wind blew.
Fair. That is true.
Sponsored by Samsung.
How do you feel that we're 3 minutes away from the pub?
Hungry.
Fair, same. I need a wee. I need water, and then I'll eat some food. I have never been so excited for food. That's a decent amount of fish as well. Round two, let's go.
Yep.
Yeah, I've had to plait my hair. The weird drizzly weather is just making it go frizzy. But we're off again for round two.
Oh, this way. This way, sorry.
Are you sure?
The sign.
Are you sure? Because
have a look.
That looks more like a path. That is.
Have a look there.
A bean. Does that say? Okay, that does say that way, but that sounds confusing. You should. I think you should just swing across that. We've got to get over there to that path and pass all this boggy mud first. Go on, you can do it. I think that stick was a better one. It did wobble a bit, but you just got to walk quite narrowly across it. It's the initial. shall I just lead you here?
1 hour later.
Shall I go around?
You just stranded them.
2 hours later.
I think. Oh, do you want me to find you some logs to lay down?
No.
Are you sure?
I was gonna have to go your way.
I think you are. You're just gonna have to brave that first bit of squelchy mud.
I'm scared of it. I just don't want my feet to go through hypothermia.
Find a solid bit. You gotta have good balance now. Go on. Go on. You got this. Go. Yay! I hate to break it to you, but this is a little bit muddy too. What's wrong?
Me. I didn't walk with you.
You did volunteer.
Look!
Yeah, I know!
They were black!
And now they're brown. That's how mud works.
Like chicken corner.
There's an actual. Oh, wait, what? We're going off the road. Oh, I got excited for a minute. Oh, I thought we had reached civilization for a minute. Go on then, what have you got?
So I got one from Mr. Big Z, Big Zach. Galau.
Yeah.
What is your addiction? Caffeine.
I was going to say caffeine for you.
What about for you? Yours is bread, probably. I'm walking on.
Yeah, I would say bread. I would happily sit and eat a loaf of bread, which I did. Literally, I sat and finished the loaf of bread before dinner yesterday. It was great, but it has to specifically be Tesco multi-seed loaf.
That is a bit of you, isn't it?
Yeah. Oh, it is. There's nothing that beats it.
Next one.
Yeah.
Who's the biggest simp in the relationship? I think I know the answer.
Go on.
You. Why?
Do you know what I think?
What's your reasoning?
Every Wednesday and Thursday you bring me in a coffee.
Fair. I can't argue with that.
You walk from your house and bring me a coffee.
That is fair. I can't really argue with that, can I?
That was from Annie. And she also asked me another one.
Go on.
If you had to pick between Harry Potter or Soph, who would you pick?
Choose wisely here.
What if I said Akio Soph? To all you Potter fans, you'd know what I mean.
What does that mean?
We'll find out, won't we?
You can't leave me hanging like that. What does it mean?
Basically, if you want something, you say Akio, followed by the thing that you
want
to get.
That you want. So you're saying you want me?
So if I put this monster on the floor.
Yeah.
And I went, Akio monster, it'll come to me.
Okay.
Akio Soph.
I was a bit too enthusiastic. I'm now stuck in a really low score.
Let's go.
I have to get up that way because if not, my knees hurt. There we go. That is not a bad view at all. Actually, it doesn't look as good on camera. However, in real life, that is a really nice view.
And there's also a plane literally just around the corner.
There is. Yeah, there's a random plane. That weird thing there is a plane. Why is there just a random patch of really nice grass? Why can we not carry on this path? Why do we have to do this one instead of... Oh, it's definitely this way, isn't it? The muddier the path, the more likely it is we're on it. Okay, another question was, what's your spirit animal?
My spirit animal?
Yeah.
Difficult one, really. Probably like a bear.
A bear?
Yeah, because I quite like to rest.
Do you like to hibernate throughout the winter?
I don't really like sleep that much, but I like just doing nothing.
Yeah. So that's kind of like your hibernation. I mean, you already said I'd be a dog. However, I often get told I'd be more like an owl because I'm observant and I don't really know why. But fun fact, owls were my favourite bird as a kid.
I told an owl I was getting married the other day. He said you to it too.
I've heard that one too many times. I'm just gonna keep hearing it. Fingers for toes or toes for fingers? I think I'd go fingers for toes.
Fingers for toes.
Fingers
for toes.
Yeah.
And they live their life quite happily like that.
That is true. Norse,
you
could do stuff more with your feet.
I'd be on PlayStation.
Yeah.
I'd peel a banana with my foot.
Have you ever found yourself in that situation where you really want to peel a banana whilst playing on the PlayStation?
What?
We're not going down there, are we?
No.
Oh.
How cool does that look?
It does look like, it doesn't look as good on camera, but it's very steep. Where are we going? Are you sure? It's still recording.
Oh my god.
Oh, look at that. My watch battery is about to die and we're literally only 2.5 kilometers away from the 25 kilometer mark. So I don't want it to die on me, so I've paused it, started a new walk because I want to at least keep the progress that we've made so far. And hopefully it will last for the next I think it's died. I think that's it.
Is it?
I think that's it. Yeah, tap the screen for me. Yeah, that's it. Hopefully, fingers crossed, it's at least recorded that. I can record the next bit on my phone. Do we actually have to crawl through that? Or under that? Can you get around it somehow?
That's less fun.
Are you actually going to go through? Oh my god, I don't know if my legs can cope.
Nah, yeah, my legs can't cope.
It's because this fence isn't supposed to be like this, is it?
No. Eunice.
Actually. I'm scared that something's going to jump at me. No! Okay, I'm proper having to crouch now. On my legs. Ow. Okay, it's the same distance that's out as it is back in. My bag keeps getting caught. I should have given you that. Oh, it's getting narrower. My legs, hang on.
God.
It's more my bag keeps getting caught. Now I'm stuck.
Go on.
Oh, there we go. Hang on. Oh, my legs. Oh, it's nice to be stood up. That feels really nice to be stood back up. And we go. Off we go again. Can you make it? It's getting dark. But it doesn't look that dark on here. But we're still going through the woods. We're going to be in complete darkness in the woods in a bit, which will be fun. But it's fine. I'm united with the mud now. We're good friends, we can get through it. We're just down a pack of Oreos. I'm gonna sleep so well tonight. We've done it. Hey, how does that feel? That was definitely more than 25. I think we ended up doing about 30, but I can't tell because my watch died. But the 2.5 kilometers was definitely a long while ago we completed that. You literally can't see anything. I don't feel like I'm telling a horror story. But yeah, we've got a car to go back in. We made it back to the house, jumped in the shower straight away because that was very much needed because I was covered in mud. Had food. I'm now downing. I've nearly downed the whole bag of Biscoff popcorn. And I also had pizza, so I'm feeling great. You had lots of veg. You were healthy.
It's because I've had like loads of sugar and all that today, so.
You were craving health.
I was actually craving like a salad, so I just got. I just went to Tesco, it's got a load of like lettuce, peppers, so a massive slab of chicken, put that in as well. Now I'm just munching some sugar snap peas.
And I'm just living the pizza popcorn life. Honestly, my legs, oh, the relief just staying down is amazing. But we have walked, how many steps have you done? You did 50,000 steps.
I did 50,000.
Mine was 45, but then my watch kind of died and my phone's not the most accurate, so.
So if you remember from earlier, with the bet, Who won the bet?
You did.
Who lost the bet?
Not you.
So, what does that mean?
I'm buying you food tomorrow.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Thanks. Yeah. That's sweet of you.
Oh, what are we having?
I'll think of that.
Oh yeah.
Think of like a steakhouse.
Okay, yeah. Very vegan friendly as well.
Yeah.
Brilliant. Buying food I can't even eat. I'm just buying chips then.
I mean,
I would actually just eat a plate of chips, let's be honest.
That steak cut chips, you know, it's not too bad, is it?
they're all right.
Yeah, they're all right. I think in total as well, we've done, like, on mine it's in about 31, nearly 32 kilometres, so...
Mine it's at 35.
Yeah. So, we've definitely covered the distance today.
And more.
And more. My knees don't feel right. I don't think I'm going to be able to bend my legs in the morning. But anyway, hopefully you've enjoyed this video. Be sure to smash the big thumbs up on it if you have. Click the little red subscribe button down below. Over there. If you're new to my channel, as well as being sure to tap on the notifications bell so you get notified whenever I upload. And I will see you very soon with a brand new video. Bye.